Well, 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 good evening, everyone. How are you doing? Three people. Okay, great. Perfect. All right, everyone. It's time to come forward. It's time to grab your seats. Sit down. Oh, we still got a little interference happening there. I'll turn that off and I'll use this. Come on and grab your seats. Find a place to sit down. Top up a beverage. Get what you'd like for a snack. And we would like everyone making sure you sitting in the back row is not cool. It's not cool. We want to make sure everybody at home sees folks here, that we have a beautiful in-studio audience. So we want to make sure that all the seats are filled. And please make sure to pre-register on the Giving Events site to bid on the silent auction, make a donation, and buy the famous mystery envelopes. The time is now 6:49. And the mystery envelopes are going on sale at exactly 6:55 online. So you got to get registered. And if you're not sure how, folks, if you look on the back of the seat in front of you, all the details are there. Our gala is going to start in exactly 10 minutes. We are broadcasting live tonight. So that means we need everybody in their seats and ready to go. Thank you.
Do you think it's the...
I'm trying another...
I have it on right now. All right, everybody, it is time. I really need you folks. No, there we go again. This way, look at all of these champions. Look at all of these beautiful people. Follow along, follow along, follow along. And here we are. Good evening, everyone. Yeah. Excellent. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Gala Your Way Gallery of Champions in support of the Cancer Assistance Program and proudly presented by Johnston Chrysler. My name is Lane the Auctionista, and I gotta tell you, kids, I am so excited to be here with you tonight. I get to be your show host and fundraiser yet again. And can you believe it that this year, the Cancer Assistance Program is celebrating, are you ready for this? 29 years of providing free services for cancer patients and their families. Tonight, we are thrilled to have you join us both virtually. Hi, everybody at home. And guess what? We got real people here tonight. Like, I mean, real, honest-to-goodness people. We are here at the gorgeous Art Gallery of Hamilton, and this is what I'm talking about, kids. Gala your way. Yeah. So we heard from so many of you, especially our CAP clients, about how great it was to attend safely in the comfort of your home. And it's important to us that everyone feel included, because that's what it's all about. And we knew we could count on all of you, our donors right here, and everybody here at home, to be here for us this year. I promise you from the bottom of my heart that this will be an inspirational evening for all. Tonight, our theme is Gallery of Champions. We open the show with a walk through the Gallery of Champions, showcasing our donors, our volunteers, and those of you who are caring for family members with cancer. And what a wonderful start to the evening. And that is just a handful of the champions who are supporting our clients with help when they really need it most. So, those of you who know me, you know exactly why I'm here. I am very passionate about philanthropy. I am very, very passionate, and tonight our goal is to raise $40,000 in charitable donations within this hour, kids, within the hour. These critical funds will support cancer patients in the greater Hamilton community with free practical services. And we have such a special night ahead, and we appreciate all of you that have tuned in from home and those of you real people that are really here with us in the room. I can already feel the support that's already coming my way. And I gotta tell you something, let me just talk to the people here in the room. After 3 years of being in a studio, my goodness, it's nice to see you. Is it nice to see me too? Yeah, come on, let's get some love in the room. Love in the room. I see so many people that I know, and one of my faves is Sam Matina and family. Sam was our speaker last year, and it's such a pleasure to have him and his family here with us tonight. Folks, here's the truth. Cancer does not take a break. Cancer patients and families require our help now more than ever. And CAP is here to provide that help when it is needed. And that is because of all of you here tonight and all of you at home. I love you dearly. With no sustainable government funding, CAP relies greatly on the generous support of our community. And proceeds from events held throughout the year, and particularly this signature gala, raised the significant funds needed to meet this increased demand. And tonight, we all have the opportunity to once again make a huge impact for those who rely on CAP's free services. So, what do you say, kids? Shall we get on with the show? Shall we get on with the show? Yeah. I don't have my head mic going here, so I am kind of in. Can you feel this energy? That's like, I just want to come down here and just hug all of you. So tonight we've got entertainment, we've got fabulous online auction items, and can I just have a drum roll, please? The oh-so-ever-popular CAP Mystery Envelopes. The first round of envelopes launched just a few minutes ago, and they're already sold out. Yay! Sold out! out already. Already. But don't worry. We have another set of mystery envelopes launching near the end of the show. So stay tuned. If you missed the first round, be sure you try your luck again, because we have over 300 envelopes. And of course, every envelope is a guaranteed prize valued between $25 million and $100 million. $25 to $100. You know, you folks love these things. It's like you cannot get enough of these signature Cap Gala envelopes. And good on you. Good on you. That's great. All right. Purchasers will be contacted after the event to arrange pickup of the auction and envelope prizes. Prizes can be picked up starting Wednesday, November the 15th. Please, my dear hearts, don't show up at the Cap offices before that, because there's going to be nobody there giving away stuff and giving you prizes. So don't show up before Wednesday, November the 15th. And speaking of the auction, guess who's here with us tonight? The camera pans over to Brianne painting over there. Hi, Brianne. This is Brianne Service, a talented local painter, and she is capturing our evening with a live painting. Yes, folks, you are going to be able to bid on this beautiful, one-of-a-kind art piece this evening. It's going to be added to the online silent auction after the show when we reveal what her champion inspiration creates. Let's give Brianne a nice, warm welcome. From here, that looks like me. Dark hair, dark eyes, and a microphone. Oh, shoot, there's a mustache in there. Okay. No, that's not me. All right, my dear friends, it's time to be inspired as we share stories of our CAP champions and raise funds for the Cancer Assistance Program. The Cancer Assistance Program is grateful to have the ongoing and so generous support of our presenting sponsor, Johnston Chrysler. Please meet Bill Johnston, President Johnston Chrysler, to welcome you this evening. Bill, it's so nice to see you.
Well, we'll attempt to do this without glasses. We'll see. I'm in between right now. Welcome to the 2023 Cancer Assistance Program Gallery of Champions Gala. It's great to have everybody here. My name is Bill Johnston, as you understand, from Johnston Chrysler. On behalf of my family, thank you for taking the time to support such a great cause. And it is wonderful to see so many of you in person. Cancer Assistance Program holds a special place in my family's heart. Both my parents are cancer survivors and have experienced firsthand the emotional toil and the stress that fighting this disease takes. My family has been very fortunate that we have not struggled for support, whether that be personal care items, safety equipment, rides, or nutritional items. But many families in our community are not that fortunate. The bottom line is cancer is expensive, and that is where CAP comes in. Each year CAP provides, and I'd look these up, 6,000 rides to appointments, over 1,000 free parking spots, 3,000 packages of incontinence products, 3,000 packages of nutritional supplements, over 1,000 pre-prepared meals, 1,500 deliveries of items, and much more. All of this requires financial support that comes from events like this evening. So thank you for taking the time to attend this evening's gala, whether it's in person or whether it's virtually. And thank you in advance for opening your wallets this evening to support a great organization. Good evening.
Thank you, Bill. Thank you so much. Am I good to go? Can y'all hear me, folks? Excellent. I'm hands-free, baby. That's all I ever... Release me. Just release me. All right. Thank you so much, Bill. And thank you to the family of supporters. Nope. It's not working. Okay. Back to this. Okay. Could I maybe get a handheld that I can travel with? Thank you so much, Bill, and the family of supporters at Johnston Chrysler. And, of course, a special thank you to your parents, Jim and Marlene Johnston, for their ongoing support. Thank you very much for that. Let's say thank you to all of our sponsors. Now, we have a live, very vibrant studio audience here, friends at home. So I want to make sure that everybody hears the sponsor names. So what we're going to do is I'm going to go through the sponsors, and every time I say a sponsor name, you're going to clap. Can you show me how to clap? One clap. One, not 15 claps, one clap. Thank you to presenting sponsor, Johnston Chrysler. Wow, that's great. Our gratitude sponsor tonight, Leuna Local 837. Entertainment sponsor, First Ontario Credit Union. Silent auction and mystery envelope sponsor, Order of Sons and Daughters of Italy. You are very, very good. Oh my gosh. You know what, friends at home, you should see the smiles on their faces. It's great. I love it. Our community level sponsors tonight, McHugh Whitmore LLP, Brownlow Partners, Westinghouse HQ, Multi Area Developments Inc., and our friend level sponsors tonight, AJ Chase Financial Group, Burlington Lions Club, Hi, Burlington Lions Club. That's great. This is like the old days, interactive. I love it. True Vision Financial Services and Cardi Construction. Let's give them all a huge round of applause. And of course, we want to thank Leuna 837 for proudly sponsoring the Gratitude Champion Wall. And all of you can join us as we pay tribute to our champions tonight. All you got to do is scan the QR code or click the Champion Wall button on the event website. Then you can share who your champion is and why, and we can all celebrate them together this evening. How does that sound? Yes, clap. All right, folks at home, now I'm talking to you. For those of you who received the VIP experience bundle at home, how are you enjoying that glass of vino? I love that, I love that. You don't have to do that, but you can try that later at home. Hope you're enjoying your glass of vino and this year's delicious assortment of local foods and treats. Super yummy, I know. And thank you to our local restaurants and food suppliers. And you want to know what else is good? Say what, Lane? What, Lane? Okay. You want to know what else is good? The online auction, kids. I just took a quick look at the online auction, and there is a lot of bidding action going on. Bravo. Bravo. And, of course, we want you to keep bidding. And a reminder that the online auction closes at 10 p.m. sharp tonight. And, of course, if you haven't already registered to bid and donate, please take a moment to do that right now. We need everyone on board. We need everybody doing their part. It's so easy. All you have to do is click on the silent auction tab on the event website or head to capgala2023.ggo.bid. It only takes a minute. Please ensure that you have the event website open on one of your devices. And for those of you in our gallery audience, the instructions are right in front of you on the chair. So go to cancerassist.ejoinme.org/championgala to register and bid on fabulous silent auction items by following the easy steps that are listed on the silent auction page. So tonight, of course, you will have your opportunity to give your financial support to our fund in need. And you will head to the website's bidding page where all the action happens throughout the program. First, tonight, you will meet some of our very own CAP champions who are going to share their personal stories. I'm telling you right now, folks at home, stay in your seats. You will not want to miss a single moment of those stories. And now, it is truly my sincere honor and pleasure to welcome not only the executive director of the Cancer Assistant Program, but I'm so proud to call her my friend, Debbie Logel Butler. For the last 6 years, Debbie has been a CAP champion, committed to providing the very best in services for our cancer patients and their families. Debbie and her team of staff and volunteers show up every single day with the goal of making a cancer patient's life a little bit better. Please welcome the wonderful Debbie Logel Butler.
Thank you, Lane. Does that sound like it's on? Yeah, great. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Gala Your Way, the Gallery of Champions. It is so wonderful to be here and here at the Art Gallery to meet each of you in person. Sorry, there, you'll be able to hear me a bit better in person. And for those of you at home, I hope that you're snuggled up on your couch on a cold November evening and enjoying our show. So I would like to first off extend a warm welcome to Councillor Tom Jackson from the City of Hamilton. Councillor Jackson has been a longtime supporter, and we really appreciate you, Tom, joining us this evening. Tonight, we will be celebrating CAP's champions, our donors, our staff, our volunteers, and those who provide care to the many cancer patients that we serve. The dictionary defines the word champion as a person who fights for a cause on behalf of someone else, a warrior and a fighter. These definitions define the people that I get to work with each and every day, including our two staff champions, Dusty Vakin and Sheila Saratza, both who are breast cancer survivors. You're right, give them a hand of applause. I am inspired by both of you as you work so hard to make our cancer patients' lives better. You are both our special event champions, making this event a celebration for all of us who are joining tonight. Thank you both for what you do each and every day. The past 5 years, we have seen many changes, from moving to a new location, upgrading our technology, and continuing to provide and better our service delivery throughout the pandemic. During these past years, CAP has saved our community over $3.4 million. We have helped over 17,000 families. We have provided over 29,000 rides, and we have loaned out over 11,700 pieces of equipment. We have provided 25,000 personal care products, and our volunteers have donated over 17,000 hours. Pretty impressive. Next week, the board and staff of CAP will begin a strategic planning process where we will be asking ourselves, our donors and our volunteers, and our community partners, what will the next 3 to 5 years look like for CAP, and what needs to be done to continue to meet these demands and raise the needed dollars. As we look into the future, we know that the numbers I shared from the past 5 years will continue to grow. And we know that we will need to continue to build partnerships to assist us in our work. We know that we need to continue to rely on our champion volunteers and donors to meet these future needs. The work we do relies on the generous support of you, our donors. So many of you have been with us pre-COVID, during COVID, and are here once again tonight. You have generously responded to Lane's requests to raise the needed dollars in the spirit of true philanthropy. In the past, we have featured the work of some of our young philanthropists who are demonstrating at a young age the importance of giving. Tonight, it gives me great pleasure to introduce two very special young philanthropists who are going to share their story. I'm going to tell you a little bit about them before I welcome them to the stage. When Michael Sfratza was 2 years old, he was the ring bearer at his Uncle Steve and Aunt Kathy's wedding. Later as a teen, Mike began to spend some additional time with his aunt and uncle, and he remembers his Uncle Steve sharing his philosophy in life. It was to do better, to do more, and give back. This statement was very impactful to Mike and his fiancée, Jordan. During the past few years, Mike and Jordy have spent an increased amount of time with their aunt and uncle, seeking mentorship as they launched their own business and began to set up their own personal philanthropy goals. It is now my pleasure to welcome Mike and Jordy to the stage to talk, and would you please join me in welcoming our next generation of future philanthropists.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you, Debbie, for the beautiful introduction, and thank you all for having us here tonight. My name is Michael Sfaraza, and this is my fiance, Jordan. I am Stephen Cathy's nephew, and we are so honored to be a part of this beautiful evening, celebrating the impact that all of you have had on your community. Tonight, the theme is champions, celebrating those in our lives that we consider champions. We all have them, but for Jordan and I, our champions are my Uncle Steve and Aunt Kathy. From a young age, I've always appreciated the family relationship that we have shared with them. They've always been the cool aunt and uncle. Beyond the wonderful evenings we've shared together, the good wine and the good food, we silently looked up to them both as role models. As I've gotten older, nothing has changed except for the fact that Jordan and I have been able to spend more time with the two of them building a relationship of our own. Their mindset on giving, coupled with their journey in business and in life, has been remarkably inspiring for us both. Jordy and I have always adopted a mindset that is rooted in, if you're not giving, you're not living. It has been humbling to watch Steve and Kathy live through that lens, all while setting an example for us to begin our philanthropic journey at a young age.
When we think about our deep-rooted reasons for giving back to our community, we are all inspired by champions in our lives. I lost my father suddenly in 2018. That life-changing event, coupled with Steve and Kathy's pursuit to always give back, despite the challenges they have had to overcome, has deeply impacted us both. We have since gone on to start a business of our own, and our goals of improving the well-being of others in our community and living in accordance with our values have only been made real due to the impact that Uncle Steve and Aunt Kathy have had on our lives. We know that they have not only impacted our story, but the stories of many of you in this room as well. Their mission continues to be rooted in charity, but they are strongly motivated, by encouraging the younger generation to start their giving journey sooner, in whatever capacity that may be. We are honored to make that our mission too. Thank you, Steve and Kathy, for the endless inspiration that you have provided Mike and I, and thank you for your selfless commitment to being true champions to those in your community.
It's our pleasure to introduce my Aunt Kathy.
Thank you for that. Stephen, I just wanted to say, I'm speaking for Stephen and myself. Unfortunately, he is traveling on business, and I know he had heard that. And that is very emotional. Thank you very much. You are our champions. And as you may know or may not know, Steve and I have always felt that our part is relatively small in giving. In comparison to the CAP team and the volunteers, we do a very small thing. The consistency, the dedication, and the diligence that happens in this organization is unbelievable. And I can't believe how many people they have made a difference to. And tonight, I'm going to give Lane some work. So we are going to make her, I'm sorry, they make them, they do a lot of work up here tonight. And we are going to offer $40,000 to the match program, and we hope. You're welcome. We hope everyone can come together and meet that. That's our goal, and I know you can do it. I know everyone can do it.
Thank you. Thank you, Kathy. Am I hot here? Yes. First of all, if you're not giving, you're not living. I love that. That is really beautiful. Those are words to live by, my friends. And Kathy and Steve, those of you who have been with us the last several years, you know that Kathy and Steve have stepped up in a big way every single year. But this year, a $40,000 match gift, that's huge for us. And thank you so much. We love you. We love you. Let's clap for them right now. So to Kathy and Steve, you know, you continue to be champions for cancer patients and their families. You truly do understand the struggles, the challenges that these families and their caregivers face, and you want to make a difference. And as I said, you know, your significant gifts have really, they have catapulted our fundraising. They have taken our fundraising efforts to a completely new place. And it's people like you that step up, that take the lead, that truly inspire others to follow suit. And we cannot thank you enough. We are so incredibly grateful. As we know, as we know, CAPS needs are continuing to grow. You heard the numbers. They are astounding. I think, Debbie, you said you've helped over 17,000 people. That's incredible. So, as we move on to the night, of course, I want to thank Michael and Jordy. Thank you for being our champions and our young philanthropists. You will truly pave the way for the next generation. And what a beautiful tribute to your Aunt Kathy and Uncle Steve. So let me just pause in this moment about this $40,000, and I want to make sure that everybody understands what this means for us tonight. If you haven't been with us and you're new to the event, that means as soon as the rest of us raise $40,000, that's everybody here in this room, plus everybody here at home, we are going to instantly turn $40,000 into $80,000. We're gonna double up. And if there's any financial advisors out there, that is very good ROI right there. Very, very good. So I, for one, don't want to let this opportunity slip through our fingers. Up to 40,000. We do not want to let Steve and Kathy down. We want them writing that full check tonight. Not a penny short of $40,000. It's going to be amazing. And I know we're going to do it. All right, my friends, you are about to meet Gord Cruikshanks. He's been a volunteer at CAP for 10 months, a short 10 months. And this is Gord's first volunteer position, and he loves it. You're going to see that shortly. Gord is the former owner of Cruikshanks Clothing for Men and Women in Dundas, and he certainly values the importance of community support. Gord is a very kind, very passionate human being, and he is a champion for CAP clients. Please meet Gord Cruikshanks.
When I began working for CAP, I didn't know what to expect. I had no expectations. I just simply jumped into it. And I was nervous the first few days that I drove. During my business career, I would have clients that would come into my shop. And they had retired, and they had said that they were doing volunteer work for one organization or another. And how much of a reward they got out of doing it. And frankly, I didn't know what they meant, because my whole life was wrapped up in running my business. But after I started doing work here, I found out pretty fast what the reward was. If I can drive someone to an appointment in the morning and make that half hour trip just a little bit lighter for them and perhaps share a laugh, I feel as though I've done something really effective. Sometimes it can be a little emotional for me. I've driven young people. I've driven elderly people and lots of different types of men and women in between. There's one young fellow who lives in our community. He's only in his late 20s, and he's in really poor shape. And we had a very, very nice conversation in the car one morning when he and his mother were coming into the hospital. And his condition stuck with me through the day. And when I went home at night, I couldn't get it in one night. And it's such an indiscriminate illness. I think the client, when I drive them, hopefully is getting a little bit of relief from the stress or the worry or the fear that he or she might have. And that's why I like to try and keep it light. I don't want to feel as though I'm driving somebody to something that's going to be a really unpleasant experience. What keeps me coming back is the satisfaction that I get. I'm doing something for others. And perhaps that's a little bit selfish. But one of the reasons I do it is just because I like to feel as though I'm contributing something to somebody else. When I hear the word champions being used, I think of a winner. I think of the hurdler who wins the Olympic gold. I think of the horse that wins the race. When it comes to CAP clients, they're winners. Because the one thing I have found, I would say 99% of the people I have driven, they are way more positive than I ever imagined that someone facing cancer could possibly be. There are very, very few people that I drive that are really nervous, worried, depressed. They're hiding it really, really well. But the reality is, they are the real champions. And that's why I do it 2 days a week, and if somebody wanted me to do it 3 days a week, I'd probably do it 3 days a week. I would recommend anyone that has got a clean driving record, if they want to volunteer, they won't be disappointed.
Gord, you're sitting right here with us with your lovely wife. Thank you for being here tonight in person. Let's give Gord a round of applause. You know, you are a dear, dear person. That comes through in person and on the screen. So thank you for all that you do for CAP and all the people that you've had contact with. I'm sure, I know you brighten their day. So thank you for that. Beautiful. Just beautiful. All right. So now it's time to get to work. And it's the best kind of work. Philanthropy makes you feel good. And it changes lives. And we sure want Steve and Kathy, we want to make you proud too. You're putting out a challenge to us and we are going to respond for sure. So many folks in our community rely on CAP to provide the necessary services to help families stay together in the comfort of their own homes. And when family members cannot be there, CAP will be there providing the equipment, the transportation to appointments, parking, food and nutrition, incontinence products, personal care products, and free cancer-related information through the Cancer Assist podcast, and so much more. All right, my dear friends here and at home, it is now time for us to come together as what I call a philanthropic family. We've had time together here, socializing, connecting, and now we're going to connect in the most deepest of deepest ways. And it's going to be really simple because you're going to go to the Donate to Fund a Need button. You're either going to choose a preset donation amount or you're going to make a custom donation amount. Maybe you would like to give $40,000 right now and Steve and Kathy can match that and then we can just keep going on from there. All right, my job is to cheer you on. Your job is to do what you do best and support people in our community, all right? So here we go. I'm looking at the totalizer. Where's the totalizer up on the screen? All right, we are already at $5,600. We gotta get to $40,000. It's okay to get excited, people. It's okay, it's okay. You know what, there's a lot. See these little young fingers over here? They've already made like 16 donations right here. All right, so we got to get everybody going here. Get on your phones. If you don't know how to do this, and sometimes that's okay, we do have volunteers in the room right now. So if you want to put your hand up, let me offer you some donation levels. Do I have anybody here tonight that would like to make a $10,000 donation? Do I have any hands up at a $5,000 donation here in the room tonight? Do I have anybody at $5,000? Anybody at $5,000? How about a $2,500 gift tonight? Hands up if you want to have a volunteer approach you. Otherwise, we're going to see your name on the screen. We're at $5,800. Catherine Ivy said, hey, baby Lane, I'm in at $200. Debbie Logo Butler is in at $200. And there we go. We've got a $100 gift on there, too. We are kissing $6,000. We are right there. But we have a long ways to go. We got a long ways to go. So let's get some action up on that board. And if you don't want to do action on your phone, baby, put your little hand up. Put your hand up right now, and a CAP volunteer will come to you. Deanna Michelle Bodden, thank you very much for a $100 gift. Bill Evans, $200. Michael Ecker, $200. Rick Daniels, $200. Riley, $200. Let's go. We're at $6,000. Let's get to $10,000 within the next minute. 1 minute, 1 minute, 1 minute. Let's go. Let's get some names up there. Steve, thank you very much for a $500 gift tonight. Who else do we have? Who else do we have? Please, if you are looking up at the screen, that is not where you're supposed to be looking. Don't look up, look down. Look down or put your little hand up in the air and one of our volunteers will come around and give you a paper donation form. Let's get some energy in the room. Those of you that are looking up, give me some love. Let's get some energy. Come on, Bill, put your hands together, baby. Come on, here we go. There we go! Yeah! Now we got some numbers hitting the board. Now we've got some numbers. Christian Matina, oh, thank you so much for a $150 gift. We're sitting at $8,700. Let's get to 10 grand right now. I am looking for what? 15 people. Let's go. $100 from 15 people. And here's the thing. Don't be shy. You can double dip. I love a double dipper donor. Do you know what a double dipper donor is? You've made a donation and then you go, "Heh, I'm going to do it again." And again. And again. And again. And again. We're sitting at $8,700. Thank you, Eileen, for a $100 gift. Friends at home, let's get everybody involved. I want you to think about what happened there. There we go. A $500 gift. Amazing. Let's refresh that screen. We have got to be over $9,000. Ashley Leggett, baby. Hey, Ashley. It's great to see your name up on that board, my friend. Here we go. Who else do we have? We are so close to $10,000. There's another $200 gift. Here we go. Let's get it over $10,000. We have a whole night ahead of us. There is still 43 minutes left in the program, Krista. We have so much time. I haven't read 200 names yet. I want you to think about this, my dear friends. It doesn't matter what the number is for you tonight, as long as there's a number. $10, $25, $50. There we go. We've got a $500 gift right there. Every donation means so much. When we pool our resources, when we come together as a family and come together as a team, that is when the magic happens. We are sitting at there. Ray, baby! Ray! Ray, I love you. Ray, $1,000 from Ray. Ray threw us over $11,000. Folks, we are sitting at $11,000. And what we're going to do right now is we're going to give this a rest for half a second. I can see that some of you are still looking at your phones. You're figuring out what to do. And maybe friends at home, we're going to give you a chance to keep donating as well. Before I introduce our next guest, just a quick reminder that tonight the online auction is closing at 10 p.m. sharp, and we're going to be releasing the final mystery envelopes near the end of the show. All right, give yourselves a round of applause. We are at 11, probably close to $12,000. We got more work to do. Steve and Kathy, Kathy's fingers are crossed. Kathy is saying, let's just do this, let's get it done. All right, we're going to move on in the show. Cecilia Carter-Smith is a longtime CAP donor and supporter. And now, My friend, she is a CAP client. As a value teacher, mentor, and coach in Hamilton and Burlington, Cecilia's positivity and words of advice continue to educate and inspire us. Cecilia is a decorated athlete and highly respected by many in our community. She knows the importance of relationships and the impact of connectivity. Listen closely as Cecilia shares her story.
The word champion is an interesting word. It has a number of meanings. It was never more profound what the word means as to when I was diagnosed with cancer. The people who have been on my team, and I'm lucky to have a big team, I don't think that they realize that they're champions. They're winners. They're selfless. But around comparing champions on a podium in a race of any kind, or a team sport for the Stanley Cup or the Grey Cup, that's quite different than being surrounded by champions, many of whom are volunteers. As outgoing as I am on the surface, I'm really quite a private person. And when I was diagnosed with my breast cancer, it was frightening like it is for everyone. And I needed a strong support team. Who do you turn to? What do you do when you've been diagnosed with cancer? So for me, when I was diagnosed and I was told that I would have 8 sessions of chemo, I have to be really honest, as strong a person as I am and I'm known to be, I didn't think I would make it. And when it's life, it's your life, that's a whole lot different than trying to make a national team or an international team. I had started out initially with CAP as a donor, and it's always been my go-to organization over my career, and having lost quite a few of friends. I haven't used all the services. I may, because I'm up and coming for my surgery, and there may be other services which I require, but I would like to share something that's really significant for me. The staff are so welcoming and so engaging, and what they do is they invite you to come and sit and chat with them. The comfort that they bring to you is really amazing, and they have nothing but time for you. But I often think and reflect about people who are on their own and don't have a large base of support. They need to know that not just the physical services that are available there, the chairs and the wheelchairs and the prosthetics and all kinds of things that are available, they're people first. Many people know at the Jerevinsky and other hospitals, they have a bell that you ring when you complete your treatments to somewhat celebrate the fact that you made it through that. I thought a lot about that. I'm not at the finish line yet, and I wanted to wait till I reached the finish line. And what I really liked about the Cancer Assistant Program is I was given a suggestion that when I reach the finish line, that someone from the Cancer Assistant Program might walk with me back to the Jerevinsky, and I would ring the bell. And isn't that a wonderful thought? That we would do it together, because they were there for me. You know, I would often park. There's another wonderful example of what the Cancer Assistant Program would provide for me and others. It's a few blocks, but wouldn't it be a wonderful trip to walk together from the parking lot at the 555 Concession Street back up those stairs with nothing but joy, and stand there and together ring that bell? It takes a lot of work, takes a lot of discipline. There are hills, there are valleys, and you have to turn to others to dig you out and get you out of that hole in the valley in order to get to the next step, to get to the finish line. My involvement and my recognition and respect for the Cancer Assistant Program is quite deep-rooted. We all have an opportunity to assist the Cancer Assistant Program. This toast is for all of you who are champions to so many. This toast is to my team. It's to my oncologists, my surgeons, my clinicians, everyone who's looked after me. But it's also especially for my friends at the Cancer Assistant Program. I ask you to reach out to them, not just in a physical way, but from your pockets, because you never know when you might need a return. I never imagined that I would need such a return. I'm blessed to have them all on my team. This is for you.
Cecilia, you're extraordinary. Cecilia is here with us this evening, and I had the great pleasure of having some time with Cecilia before the show started. And I met her two teammates. You flank her. It's a beautiful thing just watching how you sat down, one on either side of her. But here, I got to tell you this. So we're chatting, and Cecilia says, oh, these two gals here, they used to be my students. You met them when they were 14, and they just celebrated 55 years of friendship. And they have been standing by your side the entire time, and you can just feel the love and the respect there. It's beautiful. Thank you, Cecilia, for sharing. And of course, we wish you much, much success with the remainder of your cancer race. You are a champion and an inspiration. We know that cancer cannot be managed alone, and it is isolating. That's very clear. And cancer treatments impact the immune system of patients, making them highly vulnerable to other illness. And so as a result, cancer patients must limit the number of individuals who support them. And this places unprecedented demands on caregivers, most and many who are family members. They're forced to become those caregivers. And CAP helps with this vital care by becoming an extension of a patient's circle of support. So, of course, CAP is so grateful to have incredible volunteers and donors of all ages who support their services. And while I was watching the video, I was given some cards here to say thank you to the following people that made a donation while the video was going on. And so we have $250 from Karen Bowker. Thank you very much. And $250 from Sandy Schwer. Yes, you may clap. You may clap. You may clap. Dr. Hal Herte, $500 came in. And who else? John Kislinski, $1,000. $1,000 from John. Lou and Sylvia Sino, $200. Keep clapping. Marie Ann Vortman, $500. And who else do we have? Jim and Audrey, Van Der Veeken. They are here in the room, and they have graciously given $1,000. That's what I'm talking about. That is what I am talking about. I want to take just one moment. And I just want to talk about privilege a little bit. And I want you to look around the room and think about where we are and think about our lives and how we can use our privilege to benefit the people that we are supporting tonight. That's what it's all about. So Steve and Kathy, we're going to take a look. We're going to see where we're at with our totalizer. And right now we are sitting at $18,334. And I want to just say to you, my dear friends, this is the moment. Tonight is the night you plant your flag beside CAP. None of us knows what the future will hold, but knowing that CAP is there You said that so beautifully, Cecilia. We just don't know what's going to be around the corner for us. And knowing that Cap is there is very, what's the word? Makes you feel at peace and knowing somebody's going to be there for you. So if you haven't had an opportunity to donate, if you haven't done something tonight, I am asking you to. All our friends at home, I am asking you to open up your phones and get involved. I want you to think about what we can make happen if everybody comes together, if everybody does what they can. And so right now we are sitting at $19,534. Come on, my friends. I am looking for two people to give $10,000 each. Don't laugh. If you don't ask, you don't get. And it happens every night of the week. How about four heroes or sheroes that'll give $5,000 each? 10 people to give a $2,000 gift. 20 people to give a $1,000 gift. Let's get some more names up on this board. We're still sitting at $19,634. Let's get some names up on this board. You know what? We have always come together. We have always pooled our resources. We have always done what needs to be done. Thank you, Jim. Thank you so much. And Erica Jankovic is in at $25. And there we go. Emily McDonald! $1,000. There we go. Come on, let's get some energy in this room, folks. Here we go. George Vanderberg, $1,000 just came in. Another $1,000. I don't know what that's in there, but we are now over $20,000. We've got to keep that number flowing. We have got to get everybody's name up on that board tonight. It's so critically important. You know, this event is a critical night for CAP. I think we all know that. We're all here supporting. We need every single one of you. We are sitting at $20,634, and we have got to meet our $40,000 goal. So we are going to keep moving along. Has everybody donated in this room? I know that's a very forward question. Yeah, I'm getting a lot of yeses. So I want to thank you all for donating. And we've got another name coming this way. Two names, Loretta and Pat Musso, $250. Ken Francie, $1,000. There's another $1,250 to add to our total. All right. Thank you, everybody, for your gifts. You are, yes? Do you have more? Oh, okay, that's no worries. We are going to get there. All right, we are so grateful to all of you and everybody at home. Thank you so much for making a donation. So right now, we can put our focus back onto that online auction, and you can snap up those final mystery envelopes. You know what I always say? Keep your eyes on your fries, your prize, and those air fryers. Because they, you know, I don't know what it is. Air fryers still are like, they fly off the shelves. All right. We are now heading into a really special moment in our program. There is a song that was extremely meaningful to Cecilia during her athletic career. And this song has helped her through her cancer journey so far. As a celebratory tribute to Cecilia, I'd like to invite some really special folks to the stage. Cecilia taught at Bishop Ryan High School during her career, and here to perform for us tonight are Bishop Ryan music teacher Nancy Boss, along with four incredibly talented students. Please welcome Bishop Ryan Music.
waves roll on over the waters, and the ocean cries. We look to our sons and daughters to explain our lives. As if a child could tell us why, that as sure as the sun rises, as sure as the sea, as sure as the wind in the trees, we rise again in the faces of our children. We rise again in the voices of our song. We rise again in the waves out on the ocean. And then we rise again. When the light goes dark with the forces of creation across the stormy sky, to reincarnation to explain our lives. As if a child could tell us why, that as sure as the sun rises, as sure as the sea, as sure as children, we rise again in the voices of our song. We rise again in the waves out on the ocean. And then we rise again. We rise again in the faces of our children. We rise again in the voices of our song. We rise again in the waves out on the ocean, and then we rise again, and then we rise again.
Thank you so much. That was incredible. Incredible. Oh. What a beautiful moment. Your voices are incredible. Beautiful. Thank you so much. And yeah, Cecilia, I know, no words. That's hard for you, yeah. Yeah. Well, that was just for you, because you're so special. Wow. That was really poignant and very moving. All right. So, I have some papers. Joe and Elham Farah, $1,000. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I have Andrew Peters. You're here in the room with us tonight. A $500 gift. Thank you so much. Emily McDonald, $1,000. And I have one more. And this person is sitting right in front of me. And the Johnston family has continued to stand beside CAP year over year over year. They are our presenting sponsor. But Bill said, that's not enough, Lane. Thank you for the $5,000 gift. $5,000. You know, I love my job. I love it more than anything. And I love everything about CAP. And your generosity tonight and your commitment to the power of giving, to the power of philanthropy, is just extraordinary. Let's see where we are at. Let's see where we are at. And we are just around $27,000. $27,000. We are inching there. We are so close. We are so close. So we are so thankful to each and every one of you who gave of yourselves tonight. We simply cannot thank you enough. And our sponsors, we are so grateful. You're our champions. And Bill, thank you so much. What else do we have here for you tonight? We want to give some big love to our sponsors again, because they certainly make a difference for us every single year. Let's give a big round of applause to our presenting sponsor. We love them. Johnston Chrysler. Gratitude sponsor, Leuna Local, 837. Keep clapping. Let's just do it that way. Our entertainment sponsor tonight, First Ontario Credit Union. Silent Auction and Mystery Envelope sponsor, Order of Sons and Daughters of Italy. Our community level sponsors, McHugh Whitmore, LLP, Brownlow Partners, Westinghouse HQ, Multi-Area Developments, Inc. Friend level sponsors, AJ Chase Financial Group, Burlington Lions Club, what? True Vision Financial Services and Cardi Construction. Let's give them some big love right now. All right. Now it's my pleasure to welcome Board President Rick Deniers to say a few words.
Thank you, Lane. I'm glad the lights aren't as bright or my forehead would blind you all. Anyhow, on behalf of the Board of Directors, I want to express my sincere appreciation to you all for your attending CAP's 2023 Gala of Champions. During the evening, you have met some of CAP champions, and I would like to thank our presenting sponsor, Bill Johnson, President of Johnson Chrysler, for your continued support. Thank you, Bill and family. And thank you to all of our sponsor champions this evening. To our champion volunteer, Gord Cruikshank, thank you, Gord, for sharing your story. Your enthusiasm and commitment to your role as a CAP volunteer is remarkable. To Celia Carter-Smith, thank you. As a longtime donor and now a client, your words resonate with so many. I hope you enjoyed the beautiful song that Nancy Boss and the Bishop Ryan students performed this evening. The song We Rise Again is a favorite inspirational song for so many. Thank you, Nancy and students. Celia, continue to rise again, and we wish you bright days ahead as you continue your journey. How exciting to be here at the Art Gallery of Hamilton and have our very own piece of artwork created by artist Brianna Service, which is on the online auction and open for bids. I can just hear Freddie Mercury singing, "Now We Are the Champions." Thank you, Brianne. Michael and Jordy, thank you for the beautiful tribute to your Uncle Steve and Aunt Kathy. As young philanthropists, we are eager to watch you and see the changes in the world that you will bring. To Kathy and Steve, wow, an extra $10,000 making this year's gift match gift, $40,000. You are our champions. You both are a true example of someone that fights for a cause on behalf of someone else. Cancer patients, their families, are so lucky to have people like you. Thank you. And to all of you who donated this evening at here and all at home, you too are our champions, and again, thank you. To the staff, Dusty and Sheila, the event volunteers and the volunteer event committee, if you're in the audience, please stand and be recognized. You did an awesome job tonight. Thank you. Tonight was our first time gathering, both in person and virtually, and the night has been a huge success. To Lane, we have no words. Your energy and passion and commitment to raising the most funds in 1 hour has once again surpassed our expectations. I am sure you have heard the saying, a chain is only as strong as its weakest link. In most cases, the weakest link is caused by a lack of willingness or ability to adapt to change or adversity. Over the past 3 years, CAP has faced significant challenges and met those challenges head on. First was the pandemic. We shifted gears. We quickly changed to adapt to continue to meet the needs of those requiring our services. Coming out of the pandemic, we are faced with a higher demand for our services, with a rise in later stage cancer diagnosis due to the limited availability and ability to access healthcare services during the pandemic. Again, we are meeting the challenge due to the higher demand, thanks to you, our champions. We have also had to face a volatile economy, which has impacted a high percentage of our clients. Again, we have been able to adapt and make changes to not interrupt our services to those in need, all because of you, our champions. Having successfully faced the potential adversity I just referenced over the past few years, I know I speak for the entire board of directors that our chain links are very strong. Thank you to all of our champions and your continued support. Sorry, guys, I'm too many notes. I am so sorry. Anyway, here we go. At the start of the show, Debbie shared the impact of CAP services over the past 5 years, and we know that the next 5 years, the need will sadly grow, but rest assured, because of you, our champions, we have met tonight, CAP will be here to provide and help when you really need it. And so to show you a little bit of what that help looks like, I ask you to now watch your screens as we show you our new corporate video. Thank you to all of our staff and volunteers who participated in this video, especially Marina, CAP's very own client, who is now a volunteer. Thank you very much, folks.
Since 1994, the Cancer Assistance Program, which has become endearingly known as CAP, was founded by a group of local, caring volunteers that recognized the many emotional, physical, and economical challenges once their cancer journey begins. Today, our free services continue to provide practical and tangible help that allow clients to rest at home during their treatment and recovery. We offer a wide range of personal care support, including wigs, head coverings, mastectomy bras, prosthesis, and other garments are also available for breast cancer patients. We also offer nutritional supplements and incontinence products like briefs, pads, and bed liners. Our drive and ride program provides safe transportation to and from your cancer-related appointments. Thanks, of course, to our committed volunteers that use their own vehicles or our CAP van. Our equipment loan program provides essential home health equipment for as long as our clients need it. These items include rollators, walkers, transport chairs, wheelchairs, and bath accessories. We understand the stress that is felt when you receive a cancer diagnosis and the overwhelming feelings of anxiety. That's exactly why we're here to help. All the equipment is sanitized, maintained, and custom fitted to the client. Each week, our Drive to Deliver program hand carries a variety of nutritional supplements, personal care and equipment items right to each client's doorstep. A variety of educational cancer-related topics are available through our monthly podcast, The Cancer Assist Show. You can listen anytime on Google, Apple, Spotify, YouTube, and on our website. The Cancer Assistance Program couldn't provide these services without our team of dedicated volunteers who have helped us save our clients over $3.4 million over the last 5 years. To learn more about our free supports servicing the Greater Hamilton area, or to donate, volunteer, or become involved, please visit us online at www.cancerassist.ca or call us at 905-383-9797. Or see us in person at 555 Concession Street in Hamilton.
Excellent. Thank you. And thank you, Rick. Can I just offer you a little suggestion speaker tip? Number your pages, honey. Number your pages, honey. That's all you got to do. It's pretty easy. But you did a great job. Didn't Rick do a great job? Fast recovery. Very quick recovery. Well done. Well done. We're not done. Laura D'Alessandro, thank you for a $250 gift. Marina, where are you, Marina? You were in the corporate video. Where's Marina? Is she, they here? Where's Marina? Oh, hey, Marina, right in front of me. Thank you. You went from client to volunteer. Thank you so much for a $200 gift. Michael Sferrasa, $100. Sandra Sferrasa, $500. Eric Schaefer, $1,000. And Dr. Eileen K. Hutton, $5,000. Now, let us see where we're at. We are at $34,135. That is where we are at right now. We are $5,965. Hang on, Sam. Sam, you're leaving. So you know Sam and Tina. They're a beautiful family. I ran into you at Lime Ridge not that long ago, and we had a lovely chat. Sam, you're amazing. We're going to add another $5,000 to that total, which brings us up to $39,135. Now, we've got the place till 4 a.m., and there is no way that I'm letting you leave without somehow coming up with the other $965 or whatever it is, $865. I need 9 people in this room to just throw your hands up and say you're going to give another $100. 9 people. 9 people. Cecilia is the first one to step up with a $100 gift. I've got 2 at $100, 3 at $100, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10, another $1,000. We did it. We did it. We are there. We did it. We did it. Come on, baby. If you can stand up, stand up. We did it. Kathy and Steve, guess what? Sharpen your pencil, baby. Sharpen your pencil, baby. All right. We did it.
I had no doubt. I simply had no doubt. And you know what you have just done? You have just invested in ensuring that CAP will be there tomorrow, the day after, the month after, and the year after. What a night. What a community of champions. I'm going to tell you, your financial support means everything. And, you know, Kathy and Steve, first of all, amazing to meet you tonight. It was really lovely to meet you. You are beautiful folks, and we really appreciate you. All right, scrolling up on our screen here, what do we got to say? Of course, to Michael and Jordy, thank you so much for leading the way. Thank you so much for speaking to us and showing us what philanthropy of the future looks like. We really appreciate you. Gord, thank you for being with us. You know what? I will give you a run for money with my jacket. You are snazzy. You really are. Oh, stop, Lane. Oh, stop. That's all right. And Cecilia, thank you so much. First of all, thank you for your courage to share your story so openly. So openly and with such inspiration. And to your amazing friends who flank you, thank you so much. We need more people like you in the world. All right. We want to thank all of our champion volunteers who helped make tonight possible. A round of applause for all of them. And here we go. I want to just say we're moving up the screen. What do we've got? I'm getting some. What are you saying to me? Six envelopes. Six envelopes. Okay, there's only six envelopes left, which is great. Those will be gone in no time flat. Thank you very much. I am just looking at all of you, absolutely feeling amazing. What a night we had once again. I want to check in with Brianne, and let's see how Freddie's coming along. Or Freddie Lane, and let's see. Freddie Lane is in my... You know, that's bad, right? That is spectacular. Is there anybody in this room that does not know who Freddie Mercury is? You wouldn't dare put your hand up anyways, would you? All right. Thank you very much, Brianne. That is amazing. That is going into the online auction. It's a one-of-a-kind piece of art. It is about champions tonight, and you sure are all of our champions. So make sure you get online. Make sure you bid. Our online auction is... that was pretty fast, eh, for an auctioneer? Yeah. Our online auction closes tonight at 10 p.m. sharp. The time is now 8:25, so you got lots of time. Lots of time. Keep your eyes on your prize. Thank you to everyone. Thank you to all of our friends online. We felt your virtual compassion tonight. Thank you all. We're so grateful to each and every one of you. If you didn't have an opportunity to donate tonight, anybody at home, CAP will be accepting donations until November 30th. So please make sure you make your gift today. And tonight's show will live forever on CAP's YouTube channel. So share this event with your friends, your family, your neighbors, everybody. My name is Lane the Auctionista. I gotta tell you, I love you. Lane loves you, baby. I love you. And have a great, great rest of the evening. And what gala would it be if we didn't have a sing-along of champions to go with Brianne's beautiful art portrait of Freddie Mercury? All right, here they come, the sweet voices. Take it away. That's it for me, baby. Lane loves you. Good night.
All right, please join us.
We are the champions, my friends.
Thank you.